to Walking the Harborne Railway Walk. We start here on the canal, the Birmingham Mainline Canal. We're just about a mile from the city centre or so. And a strange place to start a railway walk on the canal, but the railway would have begun here. Just behind me, you can see those struts in the middle of the water that would have carried the railway across the Birmingham Mainline. And you can see this part of the mainline walk. You know, walking the Birmingham Mainline Canal, part six, I think it is, the last one, as we walk into city centre. Like I say, we're not too far. Oh, don't think you can see that behind me. Not too far from city centre. I'm going to switch the camera around and we're going to start walking the Harborne Railway Walk. So as we leave the canal onto North Brook Street, turn right and a few metres along the road and cycle path is Taplow Street, just across the road there. And that's where you'll find this path, which leads away from Taplow Street, and it will take us to Summerfield Park, where we can pick up the beginning of the Harborne Railway Walk. And it's just a short walk to Icknield Port Road, where once we cross over, we reach Summerfield Park. As we enter Summerfield Park, we want to keep straight, but keep to the left-hand side of the park, as the railway walk can be picked up at the far end of the park in the corner.
as we reach the far end of the park, the pathway to the left, just coming up there, is the start of the Harborne Railway Walk. We're going to show you a quick map now of the walk we'll be doing today, starting at the top of the map, following the blue line down the bottom, and then the black line at the bottom is an extended route to Harborne High Street. And once you are at this corner of the park, you are quite close to Edgbaston Reservoir, so we're just going to pop off and have a quick look at the reservoir. and as we reach the bridge crossing over Park Hill Road, the railway walk comes to an end. There's just a tiny little bit more which we will walk now, which leads you out onto a grove. But coming off here at the bridge is the best place to leave if you want to visit Harborne High Street.
And that's about it. We've walked the full length of the Harborne Railway Walk. I'm just having a quick wander around Harborne now, admiring some of the houses and the buildings, and making my way back to the car. So, thank you very much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed this video. I'm a bit out of breath because I'm old and unfit. Hope to see you again soon in one of our other walking videos. Bye.